What you got?
Okay. This is laugh out loud absurd, and I'm ashamed we're even doing this topic on this show, but I'm happy to do it because it's more straight Brady hate from across the table and from lots of other people who dug in and predicted the demise of Tom Brady a year ago, 2 years ago, 3 years ago, 4 years ago, and he keeps making them look more and more foolish, and I'm going to have to include the man across the table in that group because he predicted this when we first started the show, this would be his last year. Are you still predicting that?
I did at the time, right. But then I said, okay, I'm gonna give him one more 20.
You're gonna give him 20. Well, do you stick him by that? You just said he's washed up, so yeah. Do you think they'll just send him
home? Coach Belichick has his way.
Will Mr. Kraft send him home after this year?
He'll get because everybody has a printout of the players and their assessment, and the coaches will give their honest assessment. So I'm sure Mr. Kraft will have one of those on his desk.
Thank you very much. Point number one. I think even the Hall of Famer Shannon Sharp would agree with this, but Tom Brady never had what I'd call a Marino arm or a Favre arm or a John Elway arm because they had rocket launchers, all three of those. And the arm that I always saw from Tom Brady from the start, even I watched him at Michigan in the Orange Bowl against Alabama. I saw a Montana caliber arm. I saw above average velocity, but deadly accurate, especially with the chips on the table in the fourth quarter. As far as that arm strength goes, I see absolutely zero decline. I see zero signs of aging. I see zero erosion of skills. But let's get this straight. Just, what was it, 5-6 weeks ago? It was the night of October 14th, a Sunday night on the big solo stage in the National Football League. I watched this same Tom Brady with the, what do we call it, the fettuccine arm, the noodle arm, what is it?
That's what they said. I don't know what it is.
Whatever you're talking about. But I saw that guy outgun the hottest young gun in all of football. What do you call him? Patrick Mahomes boy?
Yeah.
Right? Okay, I saw him outgun Patrick Mahomes boy. It was in Foxborough, but I saw Tom Brady throw for 182 fourth quarter yards, and he looked like he was 41 going on 28 that night, and they won 43-40. And then just two Sundays nights ago, again, biggest stage in the big Sunday night stage on Sunday, I saw him outplay Aaron Rodgers, the guy you say is the greatest quarterback ever, in the fourth quarter by throwing for 104 yards and the 55-yard strike to Josh Gordon that broke the game open and they won 31-17. Did he look washed up? Did you come in the Monday after that and say, I'm seeing decline, I'm seeing erosion, I'm seeing Father Time tapping him on the shoulder pads? Did you say that the day after that? No, you didn't.
For the Lions game.
Yeah, please.
Oh, what did you say after that?
Okay, so thank you for bringing that up. Okay. Because what happened? Let's frame what happened on Sunday. We had just seen what Marcus Mariota and the Tennessee Titans did to my Dallas Cowboys on the Monday night, right? Yep. They just rocked them in their house. So now Tom Brady has to go play a hot team with the number one scoring defense in all of pro football in their house. Okay. And what do they have? They have a whole bunch of players just spoiling to get even with Bill Belichick for shipping him out. I can do Deion Lewis. I can do Malcolm Butler. Yeah. There are a whole bunch of them there, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so all the psychological advantage is with the home team because they want to get even with a Bill Belichick who, by the way, brought in the 14th-ranked scoring defense, and it pretty much got torched by Marcus Mariota that day.
Okay.
And that day, there was no Gronkowski. The rushing attack.
You don't need.
Okay, no Gronkowski. The rushing attack for New England mounted a grand total of 40 rush yards. So Tom Brady had 40 rush yards to even things out on offense. So all he can do is throw the football. Who was his primary target? The guy you said, Josh Gordon, who runs like he has a piano on his back.
Yeah.
Tom Brady was forced to throw him 12 passes, and guess how many he caught that day? He caught grand total of 4 passes. So he's playing against the number one scoring defense, revved up, prime, playing hot and at a high level, and he's got no Gronk, and I got to force the ball here. And by the way, Julian Edelman, he looks like he's running with a piano in his back, too, because he is still not recovered from his ACL injury. So can we look at the video here of the first big pass to Josh Gordon? If we can see the 3rd and 10 passes from the 22-yard line. Do you see that?
He dropped.
Let's look at it again.
It's a drop.
Yeah. This is a rocket by Brady standards. There's no loss of arm strength on that one. Was that right on the button on the mic? Tell me there was that. Did that look like a fettuccine pass to you? Boy, that looked like it had some mustard on it. It goes right through Josh Gordon's hands.
A lot of times, really? Skip, a lot of times when someone says the arm is tied to the legs. Okay. And as you start to age your legs, the ability to drive the football consistently.
It looked like he drove it pretty well, that one.
It's a clean pocket.
Okay. And, well, again, every quarterback can use a clean pocket.
Oh, so that makes Tom Brady no different. If everybody can do what he do with a clean pocket, okay, go ahead.
So then he did hit a 44-yarder to Josh Gordon, who got open somehow, and I don't know.
What do you mean somehow? Skip, what?
Well, he's got a piano on his back. I'm serious. I don't know how he gets open.
Skip, why are you doing
this? Here he is. He steps in. Yeah, they look like he stepped into that one really well. Hit him right in the bump. That hit him right in the numbers. That's 44 yards. But he's washed up. Father Time. Father Time's all over him on that play.
That was against Tampa, too. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Linebacker running down the middle of the field.
And then if we could see, here's another one to Josh Gordon, I think. This ball's got a little mustard on it. I'd say that's, boy, that looks like a big-time NFL throw.
Play.
Okay. So let's look at Julian Edelman, if we could, going over the middle. And if you can explain this play to me, you're a better man than I.
Okay, what do we got here?
Let's see what we got. Julian Edelman's going over the middle, and this ball looks like it's got some mustard on it, and it hits him in the face mask? What's he doing? Julian, look! It hit him in the face mask.
Why would Tom Brady throw that ball when the safety is right on top of him?
Just trying to catch it. It's a completion.
I don't want that ball.
Oh,
no.
Stop.
No,
That's a completion. Mm-hmm. In fact, that's what you call throwing a man open. That's what Drew Brees is known for. Wide open. Hit him right in the face mask.
Ray Arden standing right there.
Could the receiver have caught the football? Yeah. If he just turned his head, it would just hit him right in the hands, right?
Skip.
Okay. I'm calling that one a drop. I chart the drops during the game. Tom Brady had four drops during that game while Bill Belichick's defense is getting torched by Mariota.
They put up
17 in the first quarter.
Okay.
So Tom Brady's playing from behind with nobody to throw to. Nobody can get open. That's it? That's the doom game?
Let's just say for the sake of argument, Jenny, that Tom Brady is still all-time great.
Okay.
Why is he only allowed?
Let's not say for argument. He is.
Let's just say for this debate, for this topic, Tom Brady is still Tom Brady that he was at 33.
Okay.
Why is he only allowed to score 10 points against the Lions? Why is he only allowed to score 14 points against Tennessee? Why is he only allowed to do what he did against the Jags? Why is that? Why does Coach Belichick defense get blamed when Tom Brady scores 10 points or 14 points?
Blake Bortles threw for 373 against Belichick's defense.
How many Tom Brady threw for?
The other loss was at Detroit.
Yeah.
And who used to be the defensive coordinator?
What did I got
to
do with anything?
Okay, wait a second. Who played for Belichick and practiced every day against Tom Brady? Could it be that guy named Vrabel who coaches the Tennessee Titans?
That's Tom Brady.
What did Rex Ryan used to do on a regular basis to Tom Brady? He made him look real mortal. Oh. He made him look old and slow, dare I say, right?
So let me get this.
Because you can do it if you know how. But not many know how, and even those who know how can't consistently do it.
But why does it when he lose, we put blame on Coach Belichick and his defense. We place blame on Julian Edelman can't run. Josh Gordon can't run. But when he wins, none of these guys, he's doing it with guys from Dorchester. He's doing it from guys that should not be playing the league.
He doesn't even have the guys from Dorchester right now. Seriously, that would be an upgrade.
Because guess what they're saying? Coach Belichick said, that's what I got playing quarterback right now. Did you see him in Tennessee? I got the guy, the captain of the ship from Dorchester.
Better weapons, Mahomes or Brady? Help me out. Help me out.
If Brady is that guy, he doesn't need weapons. That's what you tell me.
Yeah. Well, if he had a semblance of a defense who could keep him in the game, they're already down 17 in the first quarter to Marcus Mariota.
Jenny.
They gave up 31 points.
That you said keep him in the game, although his playoff defense averaged giving up less than 3 points a game in the fourth quarter. I just want to know, tell me why Brady isn't allowed to score more than 10, 14, or 17 points. Just tell me that.
By the way, noodle arm Brady, all he did the last Super Bowl, just last year's Super Bowl played in Minneapolis, was throw for a playoff record, not a Super Bowl record, an all-time playoff record, 505 yards, and put up a record number of points for a Super Bowl loser. They did lose the game, but he scored 33. And guess what? He didn't have Brandon Cooks. He lost him early in the game. I don't know how he does this.
And you know 35% of his passes was to the running back.
Mm.
Did you know that? Well, and the year before Super Bowl,
if you don't have any wideouts, how do you? What else are you going to do?
Whoa! So that's why his completion percentage.
Is it illegal to throw it to your running back? I don't know. Maybe it is. Is that a new rule? Maybe I missed that one.
You see what you do? Now when LeBron James is going to the rim, you say, "Why shoot the ball like Kevin Durant? He's not nearly as good a shooter."
He's not. So what?
2 points is 2 points. It's not my fault that LeBron is one of the all-time efficient goats.
Well, 7 yards is 7 yards, right?
5 yards.
Since you guys.